Hi there! In this video, we'll cover how to define products on your website. With Snipcart, this step all happens in your HTML and is pretty straightforward. Let's do this. Here, I have a simple static website with Snipcart style sheet and scripts already installed on it. There is no buy button for now, so let's add one. Open up your code editor. Beside your product, add a new button element. Then, add a couple of CSS classes to this button. First, buy button, which is for styling purposes, and then Snipcart add item, which is the class needed to set up a new Snipcart button. Your next move is to add mandatory data attributes to define the basic product properties. These are data item ID, which is the SKU of your product, data item price, which is the base price of the product, data item URL, which is the URL where your buy button is located. This one is required by our order validation process as a security measure. You can find more info about that in our docs. Finally, data item name, which is, you guessed it, the name of the product. If you go back to the website and refresh it, you should now get an add to cart button. Click on it and the cart pops up automatically with the item added to it. You can see that there's no product image appearing in the cart yet. Let's add one. In your code editor, add the data item image attribute and specify the path of your image. Now, when you add the same product to the cart, the image is there. In most cases, you'll also want product descriptions to appear in the cart. Let's add one as well. Back in your code editor, add the data item description attribute and set a short product description. Go back to the site and add the same item to the cart once again. Looking better now, right? In case your products can be bought in different sizes, colors, or other options, you can add variants with what we call custom fields. To do so, add a new attribute named data item custom 1 name, which corresponds to the name of the added field. In this case, I want different frames for my product, which is a painting, so I'll call it frame color. Then, add the different options. In this case, they are wooden, black, and gold. You know what? Let's make the gold one a bit more expensive by adding this bracket. Now, if you go back to the cart, you'll see a drop-down list beside your product, allowing you to choose the different options. If I change the value to gold, the price of the item increases according to the amount I've included in my codebase. And that's it for the product definition. You can repeat this process with all the products your website contains. There are many more optional product attributes you can add to a product. You can find a complete list on the products page of our documentation.